Non-governmental organizations, including representatives of blind associations and industry groups, also reacted positively to this historic agreement.
Today is a special day. We will here today in this room adopt the treaty that will change the lives of persons with disabilities, particularly people who are blind or have a print disability. But it's an even very special day because today is the birth date of Helen Keller. So Helen Keller is known to everyone around the world, her legacy she left for persons who are deafblind particularly, but to adopt a treaty on this day is a very special thing for us all.
We're very happy with the treaty. I think on the areas that counted the most for blind people, everything went for blind people. I mean, the negotiations were really tough. I think the delegates knew that on the critical issues of the practical effects of the treaty, what would make the treaty effective and change the lives of people, I think that they did everything to make it work. And I think this is a treaty to be proud of for all the parties that are involved. They fashioned a treaty that was a very strong rights for blind people, and they did it in a way which did not change the overall balance of the copyright treaty otherwise. I mean, I think it was a highly nuanced, probably more complicated instrument than we would have liked to have seen, but I think that as we read the text, it's going to be a very good treaty for people who are blind, and I think I think it's good for the intellectual property system. I agree with the Director General. It restores more confidence that the intellectual property system is a social is part of a broader social picture that people are able to address problems that people have and fix them in a way that's responsive to their needs. So I'd like to really congratulate WIPO because WIPO has done this treaty, which is really important and very difficult to do. It was a precedent-setting agreement on the rights for human rights and intellectual property, and they did it in a fully transparent way. This is the WIPO is now the gold standard of transparency, and I think it shows that you can complete a treaty. An important treaty, even when it's a super controversial area and you have a lot of intense pressure groups, with the maximum amount of transparency. And I just want to tell you we're very grateful for that. And also the way that WIPO has taken care of the people that have attended the conference, the services they provided to the blind people participating in the conference has been outstanding. And so we're very happy to be here.
The International Publishers Association is delighted that this diplomatic conference is coming to a successful conclusion and that we will leave Marrakesh with a treaty. One thing I can certainly say is whatever the text says, we look forward to continuing to work hard and help improve the accessibility of published works so that more and more persons can read books at the same time, same place, regardless of disability. And it's great that we've concluded this process here at Marrakesh.
We are happy with the outcome. We've now concluded an excellent treaty that meets the needs and aspiration of the 340 million people across the globe. We are happy because it is, for me, I see it as an emancipating treaty because it opens the window of knowledge and it eradicates the book farming. I hope that the government of the Republic of Liberia will take an initial step, in fact, the first step to rectify the treaty on access to published works by visually impaired persons and others with print disabilities.
We are broadly satisfied with the outcome of the negotiations. We've always said that we hoped for a good treaty that serves the needs of those who are the intended beneficiaries, the visually impaired and the blind. And I think that's been achieved, and it's been achieved in a manner that is broadly consistent with what the WIPO has done in the past. So that's good. I hope that those visually impaired and blind persons who had put a lot of hope in this treaty will indeed enjoy the benefits of it and that we will see concrete results in the future.
Yo estoy muy contento porque hemos logrado un tratado que realmente podremos usar para lo que queremos, que es para cambiar las vidas, para cambiar el acceso a la lectura, porque podemos intercambiar sin tener complicaciones de disponibilidad comercial y cuestiones que hagan que las organizaciones pequeñas no puedan participar y porque también los usuarios, las personas con discapacidad visual, podrán acceder a libros hechos en otras bibliotecas, en otros países, lo cual servirá muchísimo, sobre todo para los países donde hay menos posibilidades y menos estructuras.
We are delighted at the authors to have this treaty because we regard it as potentially giving us a hugely expanded audience, and that's what we want. We want to be read. However, we do also need to be paid, and we believe that the preservation of the three-step test in various clauses in the treaty will ensure that our rights are protected.
I'm really delighted about the new treaty. I think it's going to make it possible for our authorized entity to serve blind people around the world. I think this is going to make a huge difference in the lives of blind people around the world so they have better access to education and employment.